Okay, in the last video we have discussed about the domain and ranges of the function, the theory that we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss some problems on this domain and range. So the problems which we discuss, in the beginning we start with one or two problems which are almost on the level of NCERT and board, and then we will go ahead up to JEE Mains and advanced level. Now you can see here the first questions, simple. Find the range and domain and range of two functions they have given. The first one, I believe, because in the last video whatever the example that we have given, from that we can do easily. First I am going to find out the domain. I'll try to remind the main point, that is what is domain and what is range. Simply, when y is equals to, if you assume as f of x given function as 5 by 3 minus x square. Now set of values of x for which y is defined is domain, and set of values of y for corresponding x values in the domain is range. Okay, now we are going to find out domain. We should find out first domain, because here the x is independent, y is dependent, y depends on the x value. So that's why depending on the domain only the range will be decided. Now see here, first domain, it's very clear. For as far as domain is concerned, there were four rules in the morning, in the last video we have discussed. So now here the first rule we should apply, where the denominator y is undefined if denominator is 0. So therefore 3 minus x square not equal to 0, from which x square not equal to 3, where you are getting x cannot be equal to plus or minus root 3. Therefore there is the matter, the domain we got, domain or that x belongs to all real numbers except two values, they are root 3 and minus root 3. So we got the domain. Now we are going for the range. Now see here, for range, as already discussed, it must be y values which are for suitable x values, corresponding x values. Now as we discussed, we take y is equal to the value of f of x, that is 5 by 3 minus x square, and because it is a simple and algebraic, we try to express x in terms of y. It is very clear, you will get 3y minus x square y equal to 5, or else from where x square, of course I have taken a little bit directly, I don't think it will be a problem for you. The x square y will be equal to 3y minus 5 after transposing 5 other side, and this x square equal to by y. Now it is very much clear, the x square, you may take x also, which gives you under square root of this, but you know that not that much required. X square means it should be greater than or equal to 0, the value 3y minus 5 by y, or otherwise now also you know it is under square root, therefore it must be greater than or equal to 0. Therefore 3y minus 5 by y, whichever is under the square root, that must be either greater than or equal to 0, and at the same time y cannot be 0 because it is in denominator, again as per the first rule. So here it is very clear, according to wavy curve method, see y is equal to 0 is one critical point, and for 3y minus 5 the critical point 5 by 3. So these all things, this wavy curve method means whatever the inequality solving that we have discussed in the class 11th beginning, basics of maths. Don't surprise at all, please. If you have any doubt, go to that notes and get it clarified. Now see, you know that according to wavy curve method, because it is leading questions are positive, then starts with positive, then negative, then it is positive. We need greater than or equal to 0 means positive area. So that's why the value should be, y should be either less than 0, because equal 0 is not possible. So open less than 0 to up to minus infinity, and here 5 by 3 onwards up to plus infinity. But this side we should take closed, because it can be equal to 5 by 3 but not equal to 0. Okay, so that's why one side closed, one side open. Hence from this, here I am writing, here once again I am explaining a little bit. 3y minus 5 by y greater than or equal to 0, and y not equal to 0 because it is denominator. Now according to Wavikar method, for y it is a critical point is 0, 3y minus 5, that is a critical point where it becomes 0, that is nothing but 5 by 3. And clearly positive, negative, positive, according to Wavikar method the sign of this expression will be, and we need the positive and 0 area, that is either more greater than or equal to 5 by 3 and less than 0 because it cannot be 0. So finally I think now you can write the range. Here I am writing the range will be y belongs to minus infinity to open 0 union closed 5 by 3 to infinity. There ends. Now we will go to this second question, which is again the same way we have to go for domain and first and then range. Okay, now as far as domain is concerned, see here, 4 multiplication doesn't have any impact. Any real number you can multiply with 4, and cos of, in the earlier video also we told you sin x and cos x is having the domain is real numbers, they are defined for all real numbers. So that's why whatever is inside the cos will be defined, that's why there is no problem. But the problem starts, dikkat shuru ho gaya, square root. Already we discussed in the last video, for the rules of domain there is a problem with denominator, there is a problem with square root, there is a problem with logarithm. So here the square root kind of something is there, and we know that to get it be real and defined, it must be greater than or equals to 0. Therefore for domain we should take such x values which satisfy pi square by 9 minus x square greater than or equals to 0, which finally gives you x square minus pi square by 9 less than or equals to 0, but after taking minus common, and you can factorize it as, you see it is in the form of a square minus b square because it is nothing but pi by 3 whole square. Now x plus pi by 3 into x minus pi by 3 less than or equals to 0, again same dialogue, Wavikar method, for which the critical points are minus pi by 3 and plus pi by 3, and as leading coefficients are positive, it starts with positive and then negative and then positive. What we require is less than or equal to, which means that either equality ke saath hai, to isliye end points bhi include karna chahiye beta. So that's why it is closed. Okay, now which means that now we understood the x belongs to closed minus pi by 3 to plus pi by 3, which is nothing but domain. Now okay, now we will go ahead here about the range. Range a little bit be careful and be cautious, because here generally what we will have in the mind that sine of something lies between minus 1 to plus 1 and cos of something is minus 1 to plus 1. But we should understand that when sine is 1 at pi by 2 and minus 1 at minus pi by 2, so at least the x is having the in the interval minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 or more than that, means at least in 1 length of the area interval where it is having minus 1 to plus 1, then the range will be minus 1 to plus 1. Similarly for cos also, at least it should be between 0 to pi, where it will become, come down to, at 0 it is 1, at pi by 2 it is 0, and at pi it will become minus 1. But here the problem is, as the domain is bounded, in the earlier video we have told you, for the finding the range, one process is like in the earlier question, you can find by converting x in terms of y. But now here, it will not work because, of course it can work, but it will become lengthy and not required also. Here, x is having a limited bounded area. And also one more thing, the cos is a bounded function. So that's why due to these two reasons, we will go with the second rule that given for the range in the earlier video. Now you see here, start from this, we will go back. We will go back means in the sense, as x is lying between minus pi by 3 to plus pi by 3, and then the x square will lie between minus pi square by 9, sorry, 0 to pi square by 9, because it cannot be negative when it is squared, and x square minus pi square by 9, it will be always less than or equals to 0, and this will be greater than or equals to 0, but it never, you know that x square is some positive value, pi square by 9, some positive value, minus positive value, it never more than pi square by 9. So from this it is very much clear, for all x values in domain, already bar bar keh raha hun, though tomorrow you may have to find out only range, still we should find out the domain first. We should see the domain, then only we should go. Unless otherwise you are sure that the range is, sorry, domain is all real numbers. So domain we should find out. So for all values in the domain, as we discussed just now, as x is lying between minus pi by 3 to plus pi by 3, this value pi square by 9 minus x square will be always greater than or equals to 0. But it will be less than or equal to pi square by 9. Because as x square is positive, it will be lesser than that only. Some positive value minus kar rahe to kya hoga beta? Kam ho jayega. Isiliye. Isse kam hi to hoga. Now again, to make up the range, we need the y value, that is fx value. So therefore, what we are doing is, here, square root we are taking. It is very much clear. And one more thing, square root means don't take plus minus, because very much clearly we have told you in functions, positive square root means positive square root only by default. Otherwise it will not be a function. If you are taking plus and minus both, every x value will have two y values, which is not at all a function. Okay. So therefore, it is very clear, 0 less than or equal to square root of pi square by 9 minus x square less than or equals to square root of pi square by 9, it is nothing but pi by 3. Now we have to apply cos and then multiply by 4. So I will do in short, because it is not a great problem to you to follow. When you apply cos, at cos 0 it is 1, and at cos pi by 3 cos 60 it is nothing but half. Here actually the inequality will be reversed, because the reason is that the interval in which we are seeing cos is a decreasing function. Means what? See here, you know that cos 0 is 1, and then you know cos 30 is root 3 by 2, cos 45 is 1 by root 2, and cos 60, where we need now, it is nothing but only half, and cos pi by 2 it is 0, means it is going down, that's why it is decreasing. So that's why your corresponding cos values, you see here, please, when the angle is between the theta, whatever is there in the place of theta, it is in between 0 to pi by 3. So therefore your cos value starts from cos 0, that is 1, and then come down, means it is decreasing to cos pi by 3, which is half. So therefore it is very clear, 1 greater than or equal to, please observe here, because it is decreasing, the lower x value will get higher y value, and higher x value will get lower y value. Now, and also should multiply by 4. Okay, I'll do directly. Cos 0 is 1, and into 4, that is 4. 4 cos of this pi square by 9 minus x square greater than or equal to cos pi by 3. Just we have seen that is 1 by 2, but we should multiply with 4. 1 by 2 into 4, that is nothing but 2. So this is nothing but 4 cos of root pi square by 9 minus x square. Ye kaun hai? Dekhiyega. Yehi bhai f of x hai. So therefore, which is nothing but y. Therefore, 4 greater than or equals to y greater than or equals to 2. Yeah, otherwise, 4 greater than or equal to f of x greater than or equal to 2. So very clear, y belongs to closed interval 2 to 4, which is nothing but range of that function. There ends this question. Now we'll go for the next question. See here, another good question we are going to solve here. Very, very good question. This is there. Means may not be exactly, but this model question is there in your NCERT book also. See, find the domain of the function f of x, which is 1 by square root of step of x square plus 2 times step of x minus 15. Step means greatest integer, they have mentioned also. You know where earlier also we told you the greatest integer and fractional part they will mention, then only we should consider, otherwise it should be treated as normal bracket. Okay, now let us go on. See, for solving this problem, first we should have an idea about this greatest integer of x. So greatest integer function that we discussed in the class 11th beginning, and I am reminding, what is it? So bade baat nahi hai. So many times the many students means fear to solve the problem. They will have a fear to problem solve which are involving greatest integer, fractional part as well as the mod x. You need not scare about it. Wo to bhoot todi hai beta khane ke liye. Ye to greatest integer, fractional part and mod ka bare mein bar bar main bol raha hu, whether it is domain range or calculate mein differentiation, integration or continuity, whatever it may be. So this nobody can do without opening that greatest integer or fractional part or mod. Opening kaise? By definition. For everything the definition is final. So now just we should know what is greatest integer. It is simple. I think you may remember. Still I am reminding once. The greatest integer function is defined as greatest integer which is less than or equal to x. Means wherever the x among the numbers which are less than that, the greatest integer. Means for example, whenever x is between 0 to 1, 0.3, 0.4, whatever it may be. So from there you take all the integers below that, the greatest will be the 0. So that's why from 0 to up to 1 it will be 0. When it reaches 1, it will jump to 1, because from there it will become integer part is 1. So 1, 1 point, anything it will be 1, and then again it 2, it will jump to 2. Okay, and again it 3, it will jump to 3, like the story continues. Okay, here also at minus 1 it is minus 1 and it till 0, and at minus 2 it will be minus 2 and it will continue till minus 1. So the story. So you can observe here the graph of this greatest integer of x is such a way that it is like steps. That's why some people call it as a step function. Okay, now let us come to the point, the domain of this main function. Okay, you understood this greatest integer. In nutshell, you can say like this also, greatest integer of x is equal to some k integer if k less than or equal to x less than k plus 1 for all k integer values. This is a simple definition of that greatest integer function. Now we will go with in detail of this particular problem. Now see here, to find out the domain of this function, 1 by square root over of step of x square plus 2 times of step of x minus 15. So let us do one thing. If you care about the greatest integer, let us do one thing. Just assume greatest integer of x is equals to t first. After getting the t values, then we will speak about x. Okay. So now see here. once you assume as t, here f of x will now become 1 by square root over of, in the place of greatest integer of x we have to put t, so therefore it is t square plus 2t minus 15. Now it is very much clear, as again we have to go for the domain rules that we have discussed in the earlier video, that is denominator should not be equal to 0, that's why this whatever the entire denominator should not be 0. Second thing is t square plus 2t minus 15, which is under square root, that must be greater than or equal to 0, means either 0 or positive value, cannot be negative. But because it is denominator, it cannot be 0. Though finally conclusion is that for square root it is greater than or equal to 0, but equality not possible because it is in denominator. Finally, final conclusion is t square plus 2t minus 15 should be positive for this function to be defined. Now it is clear t square plus 2t minus 15 greater than 0. It is a very quadratic, simple quadratic, you know. By factorization you observe 5 threes are here, you can see it as t square plus 5t minus 3t minus 15 greater than 0, which finally becomes, it will be t into t plus 5 minus 3 times of t minus 5 greater than 0. So minus minus means it becomes plus. Okay. And finally it will become t plus 5 into t minus 3 is greater than 0. Again, we have to speak about wavy curve method, because one critical point is 3, one critical point is minus 5. Again, we have to recollect the wavy curve method. Isliye beta, basic is not unimportant, basic is very much important. Class 11th basis of maths में पढ़ाने के time में इसको joke लेंगे तो अभी तो पता चल जाएगा, ठीक है? चलिए, now see, this is positive, negative, positive, as leading coefficient is positive. Again the story same as in the earlier questions, it is positive area should be taken, so therefore what it will be, what we get, t is strictly lesser than this or greater than this, which means, because equality is also not there, so strictly less than minus 5, or t is strictly greater than 3. So see here, now you can observe t less than minus 5 and t greater than 3, where we are having t, what is for, it is greatest integer, we will replace, the greatest integer of x is less than minus 5, but you know that it is integer, hence less than minus 5, next integer is what, that is minus 6, so that's why greatest integer can be either minus 6 or less than minus 6. But we know that according to this, we can observe here, the minus 2 of greatest integer value minus 2 starts at minus 2, 2 minus 1, like that, like that, like that. So the minus 6 starts from minus 5 onwards. So that's why minus 5 point something also you will get minus 6. Therefore, the finally the x value will be strictly less than minus 5 again. And in this case, you can see t greater than 3. T greater than 3 means again the same story, this is greatest integer and hence it is integer. So more than 3, integer means it is 4, that's why it starts from 4, it will be greater than or equals to 4. And we know that greatest integer 4 or more than 4, it starts from 4 onwards. So therefore x will be greater than or equals to 4. So finally the answer for this question will be the domain, x belongs to, that is minus infinity to minus 5 open, union closed for to infinity. Please observe that these brackets, whatever the open bracket, closed bracket, these are very much important and you should be very much cautious. Otherwise, there is a chance that you will choose the wrong option in competitive exams. So, dekh liya na? A bracket will change your life. Like an idea can change your life, here a bracket also can change your life. Right. Okay. Let us move to next question. Now, we are moving to another question. As I already told you, the last two questions, they are little bit NCERT, a little bit more than that. But now, onwards, the competitive level questions we are going with. And here, nothing more concepts, but we have to apply several concepts in the same question. See, again, same story. For being the domain means that to get it defined very simply, I'm going fast here. See, whatever under the square root must be positive, so logarithm of x minus 1 should be greater than or equal to 0 to the base of 0.3. base also important, beta, because you know, again, I am going to 11th basics of math that taught before the, matlab, at the beginning of 11th. Logarithm, either increasing or decreasing, that depends on the base. Okay, now we'll go again. Next, and not only that, log of something will be defined only if it is positive value, though x minus 1 cannot be negative or cannot be 0 also. It should be strictly positive. It can be 0 also because the square root defined for 0. Now here, one part is over. Similarly for the denominator, we will come to the denominator. It is a little bit big story because several conditions we have to take into consideration. In denominator we are having square root. So that's why this value under the square root must be greater than or equal to 0, means positive or 0. But because it is in denominator, it cannot be 0. So ultimately, we are getting that this denominator must be in such a way that x square plus 2x plus 8, whatever there in the square root, that must be strictly positive. Okay. Now, 1, 2, 3. In all the domain questions, first we should list up all the possible and required conditions and then we have to go on simplifying or solving. Now, let us go to the question. See, here. So, first condition, first of all, this minus, you know that the log 0 means log of 1 is 0. That's why here we can say logarithm of 0.3 to the base of x minus 1 will be greater than or equals to, indirectly its ka matlab ye hai, log of 1 to the base of 0.3, because log of 1 everywhere, for every base it will be 0. Dekh liya na? Ek nayak hai, ek malik hai. 1 and 0. Kisi ka baat nahi sunta. Log of 1 to any base. Log of 1 to base 3. Log of 1 to the base 0.3. Log of base 10. Whatever it may be. Always 0. Samajh gaya na? Koi dusra number ka ise chehra nahi hai. To chalo, anyway. Now let us. When we are removing the inequality, we have a question. So this minus will come here. And one more thing, when we are removing this minus, it will go to power, because we have a relation that in logarithm, because we are having a formula, b log a equals to logarithm of a to the power of b. Okay, there are four important logarithm formulae: log a b equal to log a plus log b, log of a by b equal to log a minus log b, and b log a is equal to log a power b, and one more formula is also there. Okay, I'll discuss whenever the time comes, but these four logarithm formula are everywhere useful for you. Now it will become logarithm of x minus 1 whole power minus 1 base 0.3 greater than or equals to logarithm of 1 to the base of 0.3. Now log of something, hence you can remove the logarithm. But while removing the logarithm, we have to think about the base. As the base is less than 1, it is a decreasing function. Means, as the number increases, its logarithm will decrease. As the number decreases, the logarithm will increase. Okay, so that's why you can remove the logarithm to the base 3. But in that case, this whatever the x minus 1, x minus 1 to the power of minus 1 will be less than or equal to. Here the inequality will change. Suppose if at all it will be, agar maan lijiye ye hota hai 3, koi bhi number greater than 1 base hota, then it will be increasing and hence the inequality will not change. Okay, so now it becomes, now here again I am writing here, if base is less than 1, then logarithm is decreasing. का मतलब यह है, कोई भी फंक्शन का डिक्रीजिंग फंक्शन का मतलब यह है, x इंक्रीज होता तो y डिक्रीज हो रहा है. इसका मतलब यह है, तो हायर वैल्यू विल गिव लोअर इमेज, लोअर वैल्यू विल गिव हायर इमेज, हेंस द इनइक्वालिटी विल रिवर्स. नाउ 1 बाय x माइनस 1 इज लेस देन आर इक्वल टू 1, बट यू नो दैट x माइनस 1 इज पॉजिटिव एंड हेंस ऑफकोर्स यहां पे x ग्रेटर देन 1 एक वैल्यू आके रहेगा आपके पास. And as it is positive and greater than 1, when you reciprocal it, x minus 1 will be greater than or equals to 1. And again, because 1 ka reciprocal to 1 hai, x minus 1 greater than or equals to 1 plus 1, 2. So this is another condition. So we got two conditions so far. Now we are going for the another condition that we yet to solve, which is x square plus 2x plus 8. See, first of all, you know, again Wavy-Curve method, according to Wavy-Curve method, while solving the inequality, first you better the leading coefficient, you make it positive. To make it positive, we are taking minus common, it will become x square minus 2x minus 8. The inequality converts into less than 0. Again, please tell me factorization. 4 2s are. So x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8 less than 0. Where you can take off x common, it will become x into x minus 4 plus 2 into x minus 4, which is lesser than 0, or else it will be x plus 2 into x minus 4 0. Again, shayad bar bar bol ke aapko bore lag raha hai, I won't repeat much. According to Wavy-Curve method, one critical point minus 2, one critical point is 4, and hence leading coefficients are positive, hence it starts with plus, minus, plus, and then finally we need less than part, so therefore it will be, means what, open, so that's why minus 2 less than x less than 4 is the required interval. Now you can see that finally we come to conclusion. How to give the conclusion? See, on a common number line, we are having three conditions before us where it will be defined. So all the three conditions, wherever it satisfies, that will be the domain. So let us see. One critical point, 1 is there, 2 is there, and here minus 2 and 4. Bhai bolo. सबसे छोटा कौन है? माइनस टू. इसके बाद 1, इसके बाद 2, एंड सबसे बड़े भाई 4. चलिए, अब वन इंटरवल सेस, आई टेक अनदर कलर सो दैट इट विल बी क्लियर टू यू. सी, 1 इज ग्रेटर देन 1, ओपन. अनदर सेस ग्रेटर देन आर इक्वल टू 2, मीन्स it is close to 2 or more than 2. Another one says it is between minus 2 to 4, open. Here minus 2 to 4, open. I am giving below. So see here, this is one interval, this is one interval, this is one interval. What we need is the common, means where all the three lines are getting satisfied. You can see here, from here onwards, these. Very clear? Once again I am saying, here among the three inequalities, once it is x greater than 1. In one place it is x greater than or equal to 2. In another place it is minus 2 less than x less than 4. So therefore in total I have taken all the values minus 2, then 1, then 2, then 4, and I marked first interval greater than 1, second one greater than or equal to 2, third one is between minus 2 to 4, and the common value is between. Therefore domain x belonging to closed 2 to open 4, closed 2 to open 4. Every time I am telling this bracket also very much important, we should see. Okay. Now please take a look at this for one moment. Then we will go to next problem. Here you may see again same story. Devil came, greatest integer. Mod came. So I think you may have some disturbance in the mind. So but see here, सोच रहा होगा अरे है ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर है माड़ है इतना पागल जगह कम दिया. सोचिए बेटा जगह क्यों कम दिया है. सो हियर वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट एक्चुअल इज द क्वेश्चन इज वेरी सिंपल. दैट्स व्हाई जस्ट इफ यू एनालाइज विदाउट पेन एंड पेपर यू कैन आंसर. First, let us come to the question of domain. Already we told you the greatest integer sign means if there is no denominator, there is no square root, there is no logarithm, then there is no need of thinking. Think karna hi zarurat nahi hai. Of course, you may say, sir, here denominator is there. But see, x power 4, which is an even power, is always positive. Plus 1 means the denominator x power 4 plus 1 never be less than 1, always greater than or equal to 1, which means it is strictly positive for all values of x. So therefore there is no question of undefined case. So it is everywhere defined. So therefore, and the sign is defined everywhere, greatest integer is defined everywhere, some real number aayega, jo bhi real number hai sign to define hoga hi. To isiliye therefore the x is belonging to R, so the domain is all real numbers. Hey gala? That's why we have given very little space. What about the range? You may have a doubt. Okay, domain to ho gaya, range to hai uska baap. Nah. It is not a great problem. Here you observe, you may have a scare about this x square minus 1, but you need not scare about it because here x square minus 1, you please understand that for any x, for all x belongs to real number, x square minus 1 will be also some real number. But whenever you are keeping a greatest integer on any number, it will be some integer. आउटपुट विल बी सम इंटीजर, कोई ना कोई इंटीजर आता है. एंड बगल में पाई है, तमाशा पूरा इसी का है, तमाशा पूरा पाई का है. तो पाई टाइम्स ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वन इट इज नथिंग बट मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई मीन्स इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई. क्लियरली बोलना है तो इसका मतलब यह है, इट इज सपोज मान लीजिए इट इज जीरो जीरो पाई या 1 पाई 2 पाई 3 पाई माइनस पाई लाइक दिस. सो वेयर द साइन वैल्यू विल बिकम जीरो, यू नो वेल साइन जीरो जीरो, साइन पाई जीरो, साइन 2 पाई जीरो. दैट्स व्हाई हियर एफ ऑफ एक्स इज जीरो बाय सम नॉन जीरो. वी हैव टोल्ड ऑलरेडी इट इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव. हेंस सो एफ ऑफ एक्स इज जीरो फॉर ऑल एक्स बिलोंग्स टू रियल नंबर्स. अंडरस्टूड? आई हैव रिटन डायरेक्टली ऑफ कोर्स बिकॉज द साइन ऑफ एनी इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई इज इट इज जीरो. ओके, तो द रेंज इज व्हाट? रेंज ऑफ दिस फंक्शन इज ओनली सिंगल नंबर दैट इज जीरो. सिंगल टर्न सेट, दैट व्हाट वी से इट इज सिंगल टर्न सेट. A set containing only one element is called singleton set. Okay, so the range is 0 and domain is all real numbers. Simply, you can say that this x-axis is its graph. For any x, y is 0. Okay. Now, the next question also. We have given a little space because here it is also not a great problem. See, just to remove the mod, we should see where sin x is positive and sin x is negative. Let us see. If sin x is positive, then mod sin x will be sin x. Because the removing the mod, how to remove the mod? The only definition is mod x is x if it is positive, mod x is minus x if it is negative. Therefore, mod sin x is equal to sin x. Hence, it will be clearly f of x will become 1 by sin x, again plus sin x, it will become 2 sin x. So, it is very much clear in case of that sin x cannot be 0 bus. So, that's why sin x cannot be 0. Sin x wherever it is positive, it is okay. But we have taken positive greater than or equal to 0, I will take better. So, that's why not equal to 0 only. So, therefore, all x for which sin x positive are allowed values, means the in the domain. So means for x values where it is sin x is positive, it is okay, we can take it. Now we'll come to the second one. Even sin x negative, then what happens? The mod sin x is equals to minus sin x. Hence, the denominator will become 0. Mod sin x plus sin x, it will be 0. Where the denominator is becoming 0, therefore the f of x is not defined. F of x not defined. Is not defined. So, what does it mean? Therefore, we cannot take the negative values where sin x is negative. We cannot take where sin x is 0, but we can take where sin x is positive. Now, just you recollect from the class 11th, you know about the sin x. Sin x is positive in the first quadrant as well as the second quadrant. In particular, it goes to 1 and then come back to 0 in case of 0 to pi. And later what happens again, pi to 2 pi, it will be negative. And again it will be positive, like this. So this area should not be taken, this area is okay. So again you can take 2 pi to 4 pi. So from this what we can say? So 0 to pi you can take. Again you can take 2 pi to 4 pi like that. So therefore, sin x positive, you know that where it is first quadrant and second quadrant. Means 0 to pi. Otherwise in another way also we can understood. See here, suppose if you take the angle wise, 0, 90, 180, 270 and 360 in the first round. So, this is okay, but here you cannot take. But once it is completed one rotation, 0 to pi, again 2 pi to 3 pi like that. So, that's why in all the cases you can say, so 0 to pi, again 2 pi to 4 pi, sorry, I am sorry, 2 pi to 3 pi, again 4 pi to 5 pi means even multiple of pi to odd multiple of pi. Understanding? 0 to pi. 0 means even, 1 means odd. 0 pi to 1 pi. Even multiple of pi to odd multiple of pi. 2 pi to 3 pi means it is again same story. Even multiple to odd multiple. So in general we write, you know that even number will be treated as 2n. So that's why 2n pi to 2n plus 1 pi. Okay, for all n belongs to integer. So this will be the domain of this question. And just review once again. If you need in the video, please make a pause and see wherever if you have any problem. And if you want to see carefully. Now, let us come to here. If f maps real numbers to S, where R is a set of real numbers. S subset of R is a function f of x equal to this much. They have given some b x square bx, it is positive value they are saying. Then we need a value as well as range. Here actually question is tricky, not lengthy. Very good question. So here one should think of that. The main very much basics. Question is very much basic and tricky. See here where the function domain is saying they are real numbers. What does it mean? Then f maps R to S. As per the definition of the function, for every element in the domain there must be image. That's why for every real number the function must defined. But here you can see in the denominator whenever it is 0 it will not be defined. We know that this is possible. This is, I'll write, means domain is real numbers. So this is possible only if denominator should not be 0 for all values. But we know that it is a cubic. In polynomial theory we have discussed that a cubic equation will have 3 roots, among which surely one real will be there, because the imaginary values always will be in pairs. So one real, 2 imaginary, or 3 real. But wherever the real root it will have, real 0 it will have, then it will be undefined. But as per the question, it should not be undefined everywhere. It should not be defined anywhere. It should be defined everywhere. So which means that the denominator should not be 0 for any x. So that is possible only if it should not be a cubic. If it is a cubic, pakka at least ek root milega jahan pe 0 hoga. At that value it will be undefined and domain se wo nikalna tha. So real number given, iska matlab ye hai, it cannot be cubic. Okay. So very clear, ye should be 0. It should not be cubic means jo x cube hatana chahiye. Hatana kaise? To sabka malik yahi hai bhai. Fir aa gaya hero. To 0. Right. So one answer is over because it cannot be cubic. It cannot be cubic. Means denominator cannot be cubic. Now the next question, once it is over, I don't think so. Finding the range may not be difficult for you. Now, once we understood A is 0, the expression will become f of x is equals to x square minus x plus 1. And in denominator, A is 0, that's why the remaining part bx square plus bx plus b, where you can take off b common, it will become x square plus x plus 1. Now here onwards I am leaving this for you, because you take, consider, I will give the way and do yourself, because we have done it in the class 11th quadratic equations. X square plus x plus 1, you just consider some t from here. Later we will multiply b, it doesn't make any difference. So and then you know well how to find this rational expression range. It is very clear. We will go for cross multiplication. X square minus x plus 1 is equal to tx square plus tx plus t, or else you may write t minus 1 into x square, and it will be t plus 1 into x, and again it is t minus 1. It is very much clear. From here onwards I am leaving for you, because the same story we have done in the class 11th. What we should do, please tell me. It is a quadratic equation in x, where x must be a real number. So what does it mean? Because domain is a real number? No. So as the x is a real number means the root of a quadratic is real, therefore the discriminant must be greater than or equal to 0. From here onwards, please do yourself. Here you will get a inequality in t, which gives you t is lies in between minus 3. I'm sorry. 1 by 3 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 3. This is the range of t you will get. But what we need f of x is 1 by b of that. So that's why multiply b. And here you need not worry about inequality, because you know that by multiplying a negative value inequality changes. But here in the question they have very much clearly given b greater than 0. Okay. So therefore now if you multiply with b, sorry, by b, no, yeah, into b, achha, by b. So therefore you divide with b, it will become 1 by 3b less than or equal to t by b less than or equal to 3 by b. So therefore final range will be range will be closed 1 by 3b to 3b, 3 by b. Okay, now we have one more simple question. This is not that much difficult. Here what they are saying, see clearly, f of x has domain minus 2 to 6. It means that the f of x define only if x lies between minus 2 to 6. And then they are asking about f of 4x minus 1 by 3 ka domain. It is not a great problem. Just simply, it is possible only if in the place of x we are having 4x minus 1 by 3. Therefore, it must be lying between minus 2 to 6 simply. So means, therefore, we should solve the corresponding inequality to less than or equal to, because closed interval is there, 4x minus 1 by 3 is less than or equal to 6. Just whatever the x finally you will get, that will be the answer. So I'll go minus 6 less than or equals to 4x minus 1 less than or equal to 8, because by multiplying with 3, which is a positive number, inequality will not change. Add 1 everywhere. Minus 5 less than or equal to 4x less than or equal to 19. Just to divide with 4, it will be minus 5 by 4 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 19 by 4. Therefore, domain of required function is minus 5 by 4 to 19 by 4. There it is. And okay students, thank you. And in your module and workbook you are having many such questions of domain and range. I have done plenty of examples to get the things clear, and you try to complete the questions in the module and workbook and come back with the doubts. You can ask the doubts in the WhatsApp also. Thank you.